Dear students, let us prove Pythagoras theorem. So we can prove this theorem by different activities. So first activity 1. Objective: to verify Pythagoras theorem by performing an activity. The statement of the Pythagoras theorem is the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of other two sides. Or the area of the square constructed on the hypotenuse of a right angle triangle is equal to the sum of the areas of squares constructed on the other two sides of a right angle triangle. So let us prove this by an activity. Materials required: colored papers, sketch pens, pair of scissors, light colored square sheet, fevicol, geometry box. Prerequisite knowledge: concept of a right angle triangle, area of a square, that is side square, then construction of perpendicular lines. Procedure: first take a colored paper, draw and cut a right angle triangle ACB, right angled at C, of side 3 cm, 4 cm and 5 cm as shown in figure 1. Paste this triangle on a white sheet of paper. So here look at the figure. ACB is the right angle triangle, right angle at C, where AC is 4 cm, BC is 3 cm and AB is 5 cm. Draw squares on each side of the triangle on side AB, BC and AC and name them accordingly as shown in figure 2. So these are the squares constructed on the three sides of right triangle. Extend the line GA and FB such that they will meet HI and CE at P and Q respectively. Here the lines are drawn GA and FB. They will meet HI and CE at P and Q. Look at the figure. Then draw a line PR from P perpendicular to AP. PR is perpendicular to AP and meeting IC at R as shown in the figure. Then cut the pieces 1, 2 and 3 from the square SCIH. So the square ACIS is divided into three parts, pieces 1, 2 and 3. And 4 and 5 number pieces are cut from the square CBDE as shown in the figure. Then place the pieces of the square ACIH and CBDE in the square ABFG. So they will completely cover its area. So we will do this by an activity through video.
Let us prove Pythagoras theorem by an activity. So here, this is a right triangle. So by using the three sides of the right triangle, we have constructed three squares. So to prove Pythagoras theorem, we have to prove the area of the smaller squares, the sum of the areas of smaller square will be equal to the area of the bigger square. So here the smaller square, the smallest square is divided into two parts and the next square is divided into three parts. So total five parts. If these five parts will fill completely the area of bigger square, then we can prove the Pythagoras theorem. So let us do this activity. So we have to arrange all the chord pieces in the bigger square such that they will completely fill the bigger square. So yes, this is done. So the sum of the squares of two smaller squares is equal to the area of the bigger square. That means here c square is equal to a square plus b square.
Let us discuss the next method to prove Pythagoras theorem. Procedure, same first step is same as the first activity. Take a colored paper, draw and cut a right angled triangle SCB, right angled at C, of side 3 cm, 4 cm and 5 cm as shown in figure 1. Paste this triangle on a white sheet of paper. So here, this is the figure of a right triangle ACB, where SC is equal to 4 cm, BC is equal to 3 cm and AB is equal to 5 cm. Then draw squares on each side of the triangle on side AB, BC and SC and name them accordingly as shown in figure 2. So this is figure 2. So by using the three sides of the right triangle, I have constructed three squares. Then draw two diagonals CH and AI of the square HACI. The green color square is HACI. Here you have to draw the diagonal CH and AI such that they are intersecting each other at O, shown in figure. Then draw a line PQ as shown through intersection point O parallel to AB. Further draw another line RS through the same point O as shown in figure 4. So here PQ is parallel to AB and SR, draw SR through point O also. And PQ and SR are perpendicular to each other. First you draw PQ parallel to AB, then draw SR perpendicular to PQ through A. Then divide the square ACIH into four quadrilaterals along the red color line and name them with numbers 1, 2, 3 and 4 as shown. So now the square ACIH is divided into four quadrilaterals. So we have to cut the four pieces along the red color line here. So the four pieces are 1, 2, 3 and 4. And the fifth piece is the square BDEC. So there are five pieces from these two squares. So we have to place these five pieces in the square ABFG. So let us prove this by an activity. Through video, we have to prove this.
Let us prove Pythagoras theorem by an activity. Here this is a right triangle. So by using its three sides, three squares are drawn. So and the one is smallest square, then next one is the smaller square and another one the square constructed by using the hypotenuse is the bigger square. So the square which is constructed by using the height or altitude of the right triangle, that is divided into four parts. So the smaller square and the four parts of the middle shape square, there are total five pieces. So five pieces we have to arrange in the bigger square to fill the total area of the bigger square. So let us do this. So here you can observe that the sum of the areas of two smaller squares are completely fill the area of the bigger square. So it proves that the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of other two sides.
Let us prove Pythagoras theorem by using similarity of triangles. The statement of the theorem is like this. In a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides. Here in this figure, triangle ABC in which angle B is 90 degree. So AC is the hypotenuse and AB and BC are other two sides. Then to prove, in triangle ABC, we have to prove AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Then construction. Draw the line BD perpendicular to AC. Here, BD is perpendicular to AC. Then prove. By the line segment BD, the triangle ABC is divided into two right triangles. One is triangle ADB and another one is triangle BDC. So let us compare between triangle ABC and triangle ADB. So in triangle ABC and triangle ADB, angle A is equal to angle A common. And angle ABC is similar, is equal to angle ADB, 90 degree. So, in between two triangles, if two angles are equal, then by angle sum property of a triangle, the third angle must be equal. So, this implies triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADB by angle-angle similarity. So this is our finding 1. Now we will compare the triangle ABC and triangle BDC. In triangle ABC and triangle BDC, what are the equal angles? Angle ABC is equal to angle BDC. So here angle ABC is 90 degree. So both are 90 degree. And angle C is equal to angle C common. So this implies triangle ABC is similar to triangle BDC by angle-angle similarity. So let this is our finding 2. So from finding 1, we got triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADB. We know that if two triangles are similar, then their corresponding sides are in same ratio or they are proportional. So this implies AB by AD is equal to AC by AB is equal to BC by BD. So comparing these two ratios, this is equal to, this implies AB square is equal to AC into AD. So let this is equation 3. Then from finding 2, we got triangle ABC is similar to triangle BDC. So this implies AB by BD is equal to BC by CD is equal to AC by BC. So you compare these two. So this implies BC square is equal to AC into CD. So let this is our finding 4, equation 4. So now we will add equation 3 and 4. Adding equation 3 and 4. What we got? AB square plus BC square is equal to AC into AD plus AC into CD. So this is equal to AC is common. So AC into AD plus CD. From the figure, we know that AD plus CD is equal to AC. So this is equal to AC into AC. So this is equal to AC square. So this implies AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. So AC is the hypotenuse and AB and BC are two other sides. So here we proved that the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of other two sides. So this is proved. Thank you.